If cosine x equals 2 sine x, we want to find f prime of x and f prime of pi over 4. Since the derivative of sine x with respect to x is equal to cosine x, the derivative of 2 sine x would be 2 cosine x. So to find f prime of pi over 4, we'll substitute pi over 4 for x in the derivative function. This would give us 2 cosine of pi divided by 4. We can find this cosine function value two ways. We could use a reference triangle, recognizing this is a 45 degree angle, or we could use the unit circle. Let's go ahead and show both ways. If this is pi over 4 radians, we have a 45, 45, 90 right triangle. So you can label the two legs with length 1 and the hypotenuse length square root 2. So cosine pi over 4 would be the ratio of the adjacent side to the hypotenuse, which would be 1 divided by square root 2. Well, if we rationalize this, it would be square root 2 divided by 2. Or using the unit circle, here's the terminal side of pi over 4 radians. On the unit circle, x equals cosine theta and y equals sine theta. Notice how the x coordinate here is square root 2 divided by 2. Therefore, 2 times cosine pi over 4 would be equal to 2, or 2 over 1 times square root 2 divided by 2. Notice how the 2 simplify to 1 here, leaving us with a derivative function value of square root 2. As a decimal, this would be approximately 1.414. Which means if we were to sketch the original function f of x equals 2 sine x and locate the point on the function where x equals pi over 4, the tangent line would have a slope of square root 2, or approximately 1.414. Let's go ahead and take a look at that. Again, here's a graph of f of x equals 2 sine x. Here's where x equals pi over 4 radians. Looking at this point on the function, if we sketch the tangent line at that point, the slope of this tangent line would be square root 2, or approximately 1.414. So when we evaluate a derivative function at a specific value of x, keep in mind we're determining the slope of a tangent line at that point on the function. Let's take a look at our second example. We have g of x equals negative 2 cosine x. We want to find g prime of x and g prime of 7 pi over 6. Notice the derivative of cosine x is equal to negative sine x. So g prime of x would be negative 2 times negative sine x, which would be 2 sine x. So to find g prime of 7 pi over 6, we'll now substitute 7 pi over 6 for x in our derivative function. That would give us 2 times sine 7 pi divided by 6. Let's go ahead and use a unit circle to determine this function value. Here's the terminal side of the angle 7 pi over 6 radians. And remember, sine theta is equal to y on the unit circle. So sine 7 pi over 6 is equal to negative 1/2. So we'd have 2 times negative 1/2 if we want 2 over 1. Notice how, again, this simplifies nicely to just negative 1. Which means if we sketch the function g of x equals negative 2 cosine x and locate the point when x equals 7 pi over 6 radians, the slope of the tangent line at that point would be negative 1. Let's take a look. Here's a graph of the original function g of x. Here's where x equals 7 pi over 6 radians. Here's the corresponding point on the function, and here's the tangent line. The slope of this tangent line is negative 1. I hope you found this helpful.